大家好，欢迎大家收听这一期的早安英文，我是卡拉。
And I'm Joseph.
今天要教大家如何拒绝别人，这真的是一门学问。首先呢，你的脑子里面可能就会跳出来 no， 但是呢，这个其实是不够的。
Yeah, it's not very polite to just respond quickly to someone's question with a hard no, but they'll probably believe you, but you should probably explain in a very passive way why you can't go.
就是虽然说被拒绝肯定不会是一件开心的事情，但是呢，如果我们能礼貌一点，或者说理由充分一点，至少下次人家也许还会愿意再找你，是吧？
Right, if someone would ask you to go to a party and you maybe kind of want to go, but you know you shouldn't go, don't just say, no, I don't want to go, or no, I can't go, just maybe, I would like to go, but I can't because I have so many things to do.Would sound much more polite, even though maybe you don't really want to go.
好押韵呢、哦、一个很简单的例子啊，就是初高中的时候我们就学过了，比如说有人邀请你去一个 party 或者什么其他的活动，就算你不想去也不要直接说 No, I don't want to. 这样子下次呢人家可能就不喊你了。所以呢你可以讲I really want to, I really love to, but 然后呢再找一些理由，比如说 But I got hundreds of things to do, 但是我真的有好多事情要做呢，很假。
Or, you know, again, you could say I'm tied up, I'm too busy, I can't make it, but I'd love to.
很假。You know what I'm saying?
Fake.
对。就是说什么哎呀我那一整天都很忙啊，我真的是没时间呢，对吧？虽然说听起来可能人家说知道你在讲假话，但是呢也会面子上挂得住一点，也会舒服一点。
Hello, welcome to Morning English. 早安英文呢是一个为大家免费提供英语教学的频道，每天都会更新。如果你想获得关于英语听说读写的内容，我们都会在这个频道更新。我们的目标是帮助全球的华人学好英语。如果你觉得还不错的话，记得给我们订阅哦。另外点开小铃铛，这样的话就不会错过其他任何学习视频啦。对了，如果你想获取本节课的完整版笔记，在视频简介或者评论区领取哦。你也可以给这个视频点赞，点赞就相当于自动保存啦。
其实说到拒绝呢，有一个大家非常熟悉的动词短语可以表示这个意思， turn down。 我们知道它的这个我们比较熟的一个意思啊，是调小，比如说 turn down the volume of a radio, that is to make lower and quieter.
Right, but when you turn somebody down, it means to decline or refuse something they're asking you. So if you go to a partyAnd there's something you don't want, and they say, would you like to try this? And you say, oh, no, thank you, I wouldn't like to. You're turning that thing down, or you're turning that person down. And if they invite you to the party and you don't want to go, then you're turning the person down because you're declining their invitation.
就是但是呢如果我们说 turn somebody down 或者 turn something down 的时候，有的时候就是拒绝这个人，或者说拒绝这个人给你提供的一些东西。那么如果你要说不好意思啊，我不得不拒绝你了，你可以讲 I'm sorry but I have to turn you down。 那么用了这个 have to 呢，好像感觉我也没有办法，但是呢我不得不这么做。另外呢，如果说男生如果追女生啊，然后女生想要拒绝的话也可以这么讲， right?
可以的。
I'm sorry, but I have to turn you down. 我已经有喜欢的人了，所以呢，各位小仙女们 get 起来。我们刚一直说要礼貌拒绝，因为希望人家下次还能找你。但是其实有一种情况呢，你可能就希望没有下次，就是那些 cold calls.
Yes, and in case you don't know, if someone, you know, makes a cold call, they're calling or visiting someone that they've never contacted before.Without making any appointment, and the reason it's called cold is because usually the person is not very warm person. They're just calling you like a robot to try and sell you something, or visiting you to try and make you buy something.
对，大家听明白了吗？这个 cold call 就是指那种推销电话或者上门推销。像这种时候呢，如果没有意向，通常我们是不愿意和对方纠缠太久的，是吧？那么我们要说的就是 I'm not interested, 就是我没有兴趣。
And if you want to sound extra polite, you can always add the I'm sorry in front of it, such as I'm sorry, but I'm not interested.
这个叫坚定而又不失礼貌的拒绝。 好，接下来这种情况呢，也是大家一定碰到过的，而且也非常头疼的，就是逛街的时候怎么样拒绝柜员和导购员呢？
And you're saying they just follow you around and keep asking you, how can I help you? What do
you
need?
Oh, okay. And you're not really looking for anything.
Right, I'll just say, oh, I'm just looking, thank you.
就是说我只是想要随便看看，你可以讲 just looking.其实还有一种更加尴尬的情况，就是你看中了一款东西，但是呢可能因为价格啊或者什么其他原因你想再考虑一下，可是这个时候店员就一直不放过你，一直催你买。
It's pretty easy, just say, oh, okay, I'll think about it.
我再考虑看看，但是有的时候可能这个 salesperson 不会就此放过你吧。
You can say, you know, it's a little bit more than I thought it would cost, and I can't quite afford it. Or maybe it's a little bit over my budget.
这个不错，就是如果是价格原因啊，你可以讲 I can't afford it, 就是太贵了，买不起。但是更多时候，其实我觉得不是买不起，只是你不愿意花那么多钱去买这个。所以我觉得 that's a little over my budget 更加好一点，就是有点超过我的预算了，我不想要花那么多钱买它。
And if you don't want to feel embarrassed because maybe you don't have enough money, you could say, oh, I'd love to, but I need to consider this with my wife or my girlfriend or maybe even just, you know, my best friend.
这个很，就是好像之前和倪老师也说过，你可以讲，我真挺喜欢的，但是呢，我得和我家老大、我老婆或者我女朋友，甚至说和我朋友商量一下。当然前提是你不觉得这么说会让你面子挂不住，好像要听老婆的这种感觉。好，下一种情况 ，Joseph， 你来。
Like when your boss or manager gives you something to do at work, such as maybe a difficult task or something that is beyond your abilities, you can use the word handle, and the sentence would be something like, "Sorry, but I can't handle it. I've never done this before."
Handle 这个意思呢，我们知道它有一个意思是手把，你抓住这个手柄，手把就是为了去控制某种东西，对不对？所以呢，它做动词的时候啊，就是表示事情上应付的过来。那么当你说sorry, I can't handle it, 就是说恐怕我做不来。
Or there's too much of a workload here, I can't handle it. I think there's too much work to do.
或者说你觉得工作太多了，我做不完，应付不来的时候，你也可以讲 There's too much workload here, I can't handle it. Workload 就是工作量的意思，工作量太大了，搞不来。好，最后一种呢，也是非常的实用。When someone asks you a question and you don't want to give a response.
Right, like if I asked someone, how was your test last Friday?
比如说有人问你那个考试考得如何啊，然后呢你没有及格，所以不想讲，那么就不要勉强自己，你就可以说 There's nothing to talk about, 没什么可说的，不想说。
Right, it would be like if I said no comment.
另外一个类似的说法呢，你可以说成 no comment, 就是无可奉告。所以以后如果说七大姑八大姨问你找对象没，你就可以这么回了，卡拉姐姐别提多贴心了。
Hello, welcome to Morning English. 早安英文呢是一个为大家免费提供英语教学的频道，每天都会更新。如果你想获得关于英语听说读写的内容，我们都会在这个频道更新。我们的目标是帮助全球的华人学好英语。如果你觉得还不错的话，记得给我们订阅哦。另外，点开小铃铛，这样的话就不会错过其他任何学习视频啦。对了，如果你想获取本节课的完整版笔记，在视频简介或者评论区领取哦。你也可以给这个视频点赞，点赞就相当于自动保存啦。
So I believe that everything we talked about today would be very useful and practical for you to say no in a polite way and not feel embarrassed.
今天列举的情况呢都是非常实用而且非常具体的一些场景啊，希望下次大家就能用到，就能做到坚定又不失礼貌的拒绝了。那我是卡拉，
我是 Joseph. See you around.
下次见，拜拜。